The 2020 M1 MacBook Air will turn 4 years old this year, which is crazy to say out loud because it feels like Apple Silicon was just revealed not too long ago. But yeah, Apple Silicon Macs ever since this M1 MacBook Air have been a massive success for Apple. Even though the outer shell is basically the same design as the very first MacBook Air, we were all still amazed by the M1 version because of the industry-changing power and efficiency, amazing battery life, and a really seamless transition to ARM-optimized software. The M2 and M3 Macs have been noticeable improvements in design and performance, but at just about $750 right now, this laptop is still so good and affordable that I still recommend this base M1 MacBook Air to most people. It's starting to age in some ways, but it's still such a good purchase that I think it's actually been Apple's biggest mistake. Before I drool all over this thing, I'd really appreciate it if you guys can subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. It might not seem like much, but it really helps out in growing this channel. Okay, hardware wise, this MacBook Air design is still nice, but I'll admit that it's definitely getting boring. The color options are limited, the display bezels are slightly big, there's just two USB-C ports and an audio jack for I/O, just a 720p HD webcam, and the CNC machine finish on the aluminum is a little rough and not as smooth compared to other MacBook models or recent high-end Windows laptops. I also noticed the outer shell can get slightly dented and scratched pretty easily, but overall it still looks really great, and outside of these nitpicks, it's such a well-built piece of hardware without any noticeable flaws. It's a compact, slim, and light laptop that feels really premium thanks to the aluminum everywhere, a very stable, solid hinge, and the keyboard and haptic trackpad combo being so excellent. The keyboard's got plenty of spacing and just enough travel to have a comfortable typing experience while not having to worry about food crumbs getting under the keys. Being a lifelong Windows user, I was skeptical about the haptic trackpad, but it's been a life changer being able to click anywhere I want, and it's amazing for durability since I don't have to worry about it getting stuck or anything like that. Things like build quality, keyboard, and trackpad might sound like just the basics, but more often than not, high-end Windows laptops coming out today still don't nail all these things together as good as this older MacBook Air. Now, portable aluminum ultrabooks are a dime a dozen these days, but what makes this really stand out is the really portable 30-watt charger. I think this part is really underrated. There's a lot of slim laptops that come with multi-part big clunky chargers, but this is just a small adapter with a USB-C to USB-C cable that you can easily bring around and travel with as your only charger, since you can use this to also charge your phone and earbuds. Like I said, the bezels do make it look a bit aged, but this 13-inch Retina display is still performing so well. It's not 4K resolution or a fast refresh rate display, but it's actually very pixel dense, and the smooth, consistent macOS animations make this 60Hz display look faster than it is. I also found the color reproduction to be appropriately vibrant, staying neutral where it needs to be like photo and video editing, but ramping it up for entertainment purposes. Now, it's not a big display, so it's not the best experience for a long project or for watching shows and movies, but everything does look and sound nice and crispy. The stereo speakers are actually placed underneath the keyboard and they push sound out through the grills on the side. Speakers placed like this are usually underwhelming, but I have to admit that Apple never fails in the audio department when it comes to their MacBooks. The audio sounds really nice and deep, no tinny noises or distortions, and it gets really loud. It's always super impressive coming from such a thin body. And again, you have the audio jack so you can get lossless audio with your wired headphones, especially for when you're outside or at a cafe. Speaking of which, what's really nice for using this outside is a fairly anti-reflective glass panel. Getting up to 400 nits is not the brightest display tech, and the glass does get pretty fingerprinty, but because the glass is great at preventing light reflections, the display always looks so good and easily visible wherever you're at. Moving on, just a quick check-in on the software experience. Personally, I'm still very satisfied with my fairly recent transition from Windows, since there is so much dev support for everything I need to optimize my Windows-like macOS experience. Plus, macOS Sonoma has also been a nice refreshing update for this laptop. You can now put widgets on the desktop, there's a game mode to boost graphics performance and frame rates when gaming, and the most noticeable is the new animated login screen. Now, to be fair, this feature isn't that impressive in a technical sense, but my jaw actually dropped when seeing this for the first time because it was so refreshing to see this noticeable change. Apple actually included a bunch of default animated wallpapers that are really cool to see, especially the cityscape options. Then if you are considering this laptop and you're maybe worried about support since this is entering its fourth year, you really don't need to. Just based on history and how focused Apple is on Apple Silicon devices, you have at least 3 more years of major OS updates and potentially up to 6 more years of security support. Considering how well the performance is holding up here, I wouldn't be surprised if this thing goes even longer than that. On that note, the performance is still so impressive after all these years. And just to remind you, this is just the base version with 8 gigs of RAM. This has been my primary laptop for all use cases, including browsing, email, spreadsheets, 4K video editing, and a bit of gaming. I can export an 8-minute 4K video in just 5 minutes without a discrete GPU, which is still insane to me. Even in 2024, I just don't have any real reason to upgrade anytime soon. This doesn't have the top-end connectivity tech anymore, but Wi-Fi speeds and Bluetooth connections have been very fast and reliable with no weird disconnects. On the other side, it's definitely not invincible. Because of the limited RAM, it does start to chug a bit when I have more than 8 browser windows open, especially when I have a really long email thread open on Gmail or a spreadsheet with too many lines. Apple also limited this to only support one wired external display, still at up to 6K resolution, 60Hz, but yeah, only one, no daisy chaining here. But as a slim, fanless 2020 laptop that is still very good at keeping itself cool and not affecting your keyboard experience, I can't be more satisfied with the performance here. Now let's talk power efficiency and battery life. Inside, the M1 MacBook Air has a 49.9 watt-hour battery, and Apple says this can get up to 15 hours of web browsing and up to 18 hours of video playback. I'm definitely not getting those numbers with my general usage, but on one full charge, I can make it through a busy 8-hour workday of emails, some video conferencing, spreadsheets, a bit of music and video streaming, and still end up with 20%. Of course, if I do some video editing and long video calls, the battery does get used up a bit faster, but it doesn't drain like how it feels on unplugged Windows laptops. The battery life usage here is very gradual, and I can trust this to last me even if I take this out without a charger to a cafe in the afternoon with only 50% left. My only minor complaint here is the charging speed. The 30 watt charger is very portable, but it also doesn't charge this laptop too fast. It takes just under 3 hours to go from 0 to 100%. You can get 0 to 50 in the first hour, but yeah, not the fastest charging speeds here. Thankfully, 30 watts isn't the limit, and you can charge up to 45 watts with a faster charger, so you can do a bit better on the charging front. But since this is a laptop that I only need to charge when I don't need to use it anymore, like I said, just a minor complaint. So putting everything together, even in 2024, the 2020 M1 MacBook Air is still a really good all-around laptop that you can get for a very reasonable price. With high-quality hardware, display, and audio, attractive software with reliable support, and still impressive performance and battery life, this is still my main laptop recommendation to most people. Apple might want you to get their pretty new M2 and M3 laptops, but I think they messed up here, making this one too good. For me, this one is still the one to get in terms of price to performance. Alright guys, that's going to do it for this video. Let me know in the comments if you agree or disagree with my thoughts here. If you like this video, it would mean a ton if you can like and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.